Hello everyone, I am LoreChirik and today we're gonna create this Slappy from the game Goosebumps HorrorTown.
You guys probably know this character. This is Slappy the Dummy from the very popular book series Goosebumps by R.L. Stein. There was also a Goosebumps TV series and a movie. I remember when I was a kid, I was watching the Goosebumps TV series and I was so scared by Slappy, and now I'm making the Slappy, but I'm gonna do the design of the Slappy from the game Goosebumps HorrorTown. This is brand new game released 2 days ago for iOS and Android. I had the pleasure to play it a little bit. It's a really nice game. There are so much things to do in this game, like building the houses, making your own city, scaring the people. Let me show you a very short trailer of this game so you will get better understanding what I'm talking about. So yes, you see there is a Slappy, you can actually unlock the Slappy, but my favorite thing is following the stories and playing the scenes. This game is free guys, go check it out after the video, link for you is in the top of the description below. Sit on the sofa, turn off the lights and enjoy this horror game. But back to our figure guys. Now you see that I just finished the feet and I am putting some liquid clay on the feet, on the aluminium wire and also on the corners of the boots. I'm doing that because I want to make sure that the feet are stick very well to the wood base, because the wood base will hold the sculpture in the oven and I want to make sure that it won't break. As you see now, I'm mixing the clay while the figure is baking, and of course I have a timer, it counts 25 minutes so I won't burn anything. And now I'm making the color for the suit. It's not actually black. I seen the reference photo and it's quite dark gray. So I made that color. And now I'm making the legs. The technique that I use here is quite similar to my Fortnite video where I was making the Reaper. He also wear the suit. So it was quite similar to that. And guys, I'm reading your comments from the previous video, from my Thanos video. You guys just wrote a massive amount of comments. Thank you for such a nice comments on that video, for your support, for your likes, not only on that video, but on all videos. It means a lot to me and it's really make me happy that you actually enjoy those videos. But back to our sculpture, as you see now, I'm finishing the legs. In my previous video, I saw a lot of comments. Why do you call him Thanos from Fortnite? He's Thanos from Avengers. I know that he's a Marvel character from Avengers Infinity War, but in Fortnite few weeks ago was Thanos mode, so you could actually play Thanos in Fortnite, and I was making that Thanos from Fortnite. I was basing on the reference photos from Fortnite, but probably Thanos from Fortnite and Thanos from Avengers look just the same. So guys, this is just the same Thanos. But back to our sculpture, you see now that I'm making the torso. I made a huge block of clay. I put it on the figure. But back to our comment section, guys, you wrote such a lot amount of comments about what tools do I use, what clay do I use. I answered these questions in my previous videos, but I know that not every one of you just watch all videos on my channel, and we got few new subscribers, so let me answer this. In the description there is a link to Amazon, and there you can find a page where I list all the tools that I use, all the clays that I use, and you can buy them directly from the Amazon. Wherever you are in the world, they will ship it to you. But back to our sculpture, I just almost finished the torso. Now I'm making the parts of the suit, of the Slappy. And speaking of Slappy, if you are a fan of the Goosebumps series, they just add a ton of stickers to the game that you can use in iMessage. They are really nice. I will show you some of them on the screen right now. The designs of the monsters from the Goosebumps HorrorTown are so nice. I actually at the start was thinking of making the zombie monster, but finally I decided that I will make the Slappy because he's kind of a main character. And back to our sculpture, I'm now smoothing the surface and I'm placing the aluminium wires to the holes in the torso. But back to the questions, I got a question: how many tools do you have to use to make one sculpture? Well, actually I got few of my favorite tools. It's a knife, so with the knife I cut the shapes out of the clay, so it's quite important. Also the tools with the rubber end to smooth the surface of the clay, and one dentist tool that I make the lines and the tiny details. This is the one that you see right now on the screen. And also the tools with the ball at the end is also quite important. So answering your questions, I can make a sculpture with four tools. But back to our sculpture, you see that now I'm making the face. I know he doesn't look very nice at the beginning, but the final effect will be better. And now I'm placing this head onto the sculpture. The torso, the legs and the feet are solid, they are baked, so they are just not moving, and I don't destroy those elements while I'm working on the head. So basically that's the main reason why I bake the figure a few times. I just like this technique of building the figure. And now I'm making the jaw. I cut the lines to make an effect that this jaw is movable. And for the inside of the mouth, I'm using the tiny sheet of the clay. Now he looks even more creepy than the final version, but I won't stay with him like that. And guys, I was checking my Instagram account lately and I saw a comment from Claymaker01, and he actually made few figures basing on my Polymer clay tutorials on my videos. I'm so glad I could help, and I'm so glad that actually some of you using my videos as a guide to make your own Polymer clay creations. And speaking of the Instagram, if you're not following me on Instagram, make sure to do it, because on my Instagram I put the work in progress pictures every few days. So if you want to know on what I'm working right now, make sure to follow me on the Instagram. Link to my Instagram is on the description below. But back to our sculpture, I'm placing the hair onto his head. I figured out that placing a lot amount of clay onto his head and then cutting the lines is a good idea to make the hair. Guys, I'm scrolling through the comment section trying to find the perfect questions me to answer, and I noticed very nice comments from Karen Eskander on my previous video, Thanos video. She wrote, they should add LoreChirik as a Fortnite ultra rare skin, cause I would get that skin in Fortnite right away. That's true, I agree on that. And back to our sculpture, I'm making the hands, the same technique that I made the legs. But back to our questions and comments, some of you asked, why haven't you posting on the Lashy Plashy so often as you used to do? Well, recently I was busy with the tunnels from Fortnite. It was very complicated figure. I spent on it a week or something, so I didn't have enough time for the Lashy Plashy. But now I got some time, so be ready for the next episode on the Lashy Plashy on the Fridays and Tuesdays around 4 p.m. EST, Eastern Standard Time. But back to our sculpture, I'm making right now the fingers, and as a Slappy is a puppet, I'm trying to make his fingers like a puppet's do. And after this element is done, I'm smoothing the surface just to remove the fingerprints, imperfections and so on. Now I'm taking the figure from the vise and cleaning a little bit the table, because now I will be making the base. I decided that I will make the base that looks like a wood, so I just mix some tones of the brown color. And I want to mention one more thing. From now on my channel, new videos will be always on Fridays at time 4 p.m. EST, Eastern Standard Time. But back to our sculpture, I'm using the glossy varnish to enhance some of the parts, like the skin and the shoes and the head, because Slappy is a puppet and he have to look like a puppet. And here we go, guys, Slappy is finished!
Leave a like if you enjoyed this video, subscribe and tick the notification bell, and let me know in the comments if you want to see more creepy characters on this channel. And check out the Goosebumps HorrorTown, it's on tablets and for mobile phones. Link is in the description below.